are back!
We're hungry!
And we are by the banks of this beautiful little stream slash river along this lovely bridge on State Highway 17 on our way to the magnificent city of Palampur. Where Apollo Highway on my plate is determined to find some local Kangra cuisine which involves chicken, because I'm missing chicken. But what I want to talk to you about right now is this. This is made delightfully. And the great thing about non-vegetarian food in Himachal is that it is packing a big punch at all times. They use a lot of ingredients. There's nothing really fancy about this chicken. It's got lots of curry pattas, believe it or not, which are tucked into it, which don't really make that much of a difference as you would imagine, because they're put in right in the beginning and the chicken is sort of cooked with them. It's also got rice seeds, lots of them in there. And sarson seems to just go easy on the palate of all Himachal. So that is a truly nice chicken, eaten of course with rice. Excuse me, can you pass me some rice with your not dirty hand? Thank you.
Cooking Pahadi food is very simple. You start with onion, lots of ginger, garlic, spices, throw in some haldi, throw in some rye, cook it, and it's done.
But what you may not get is this exotic looking green vegetable with sort of hair on it, and it's called the
longru.
A flower by any other name, longru. It makes me feel appetized already.
Longru is a seasonal vegetable which grows here, and it doesn't get cultivated. It grows in the wild. You have to go out and get it at a specific time, and the closest you can come to it is it's sort of like a mix between a bhindi and a bean, and a lot juicier than either of those. Another interesting thing on our table is this. You might know it as the kaddu, but here it's called the petha. The difference being that you can normally get sweet petha here. It's definitely not sweet. In fact, it's quite spicy with a lot of rye, but they haven't overcooked it, so it's not squishy. It's actually slightly crunchy, and that makes a very interesting texture.
But what I really like over here is this, the mutton. And it's really unusual. Again, Pahadi mutton is done with a load of amchur, and the exciting part is it's got mint leaves in it. So it has this really fresh sort of flavor.
Basically, you can eat your food and not have to brush your teeth afterwards.
There you go.
Great.
Life is good. They've topped it up beautifully with rose petals, which are edible. Yes, it is true. Slivers of garlic and some curry patta on top. But the quintessential taste is that sourness and the freshness of the mint. I'm feeling all fresh and daisy-like. This is what this is. As the wind blows through our hair and leaves fall in our food, it's time to give you Rocky and Mayur's report card. Mayur, taste.
7.
7. Ambience.
9.
10.
Service.
8.
Agreed. 8. And value for money?
7.
I agree.
Keep in mind, if you come down this way and you want to eat this food, you'll have to be a resident at the Norwood Greens. Otherwise, you won't get any of it.